नमस्कार। हमारा देश और पूरा विश्व आज कोविड-19 की चुनौती का सामना कर रहा है। कोविड-19 अभी खत्म नहीं हुआ है, ऐसे में हमारा फर्ज है कि हम सतर्क रहें। इसलिए जब तक दवाई नहीं तब तक कोई ढिलाई नहीं। कोरोना से बचाव के लिए जरूरी है नियमित रूप से हाथ धोना, मास्क पहनना और आपस में उचित दूरी बनाए रखना। याद रखिए, 2 गज दूरी मास्क है जरूरी। खांसी बुखार या सांस लेने में कठिनाई होने पर हेल्पलाइन नंबर 10।
I would like to welcome everyone to RAISE, Responsible Artificial Intelligence for Social Empowerment 2020. Artificial intelligence has been the catalyzing the technological landscape, pushing further the envelope of human possibility. Its impact is universally being felt across all sectors. Its influence is expanding and redefining the bounds of human achievement. The future development and progress of the world is intricately linked with leveraging AI knowledge to push social empowerment. India is very uniquely positioned to take advantage of the AI revolution. With more than 600 million internet users, there's a lot of data which is generated, something that lies at the core of AI development. Our data costs are the lowest in the world. India's unique diversity in terms of language, culture, and development challenges is representative of many other countries and makes India the perfect garage for the development of solutions which can address global challenges. On top of all this, India's digitization efforts, driven by the Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi, through Aadhaar, UPI, GST, and now the National Digital Health Mission and other such public digital infrastructure, have created a unique opportunity for artificial intelligence to be leveraged to increase transparency and improve governance outcomes while safeguarding personal data and privacy. RAISE 2020 has over 60,000 plus participants from 139 countries and is the biggest and the most content-rich artificial intelligence conference in the world. We have gathered here to define a new roadmap, one which leverages artificial intelligence to not merely facilitate economic development, but also usher transformation through social empowerment. I would like to